am doing day two of Grinchmas, the 12 days of Grinchmas. Today is day two, and the flavor is hazelnut cappuccino. I do like cappuccino, so I'm interested, but I don't really care for the flavor of hazelnut. This one is just like 130 calories. Yeah, this is 130 calories, and carbs are 32 grams. So, I'm not sure if I'm going to like this one either, because the fact that it's 32 grams of carbohydrates, which means it's probably full of sugar. And if it's too sweet, we're just not going to get along. Okay. Let's see how we like this. I smell it. Doesn't really have a smell. Eh. I'm not sure. Okay. Hopefully it's better than the one I had yesterday. And I already heated my milk up. I'm using the grass-fed milk that I had yesterday. Kind of looks like tea. Like a really light tea. Okay. I can smell it now. It smells good. But we'll see. Okay, here it goes. No, it's not as bad as the French vanilla latte. Ooh. Yeah. Oh my gosh, I can't do this one either. All right, that one majorly went down the wrong pipe. So we are 0 for 2. Wow. I think the only one I'm probably, even then, I don't know if I'm going to like the candy cane, because it's a candy cane latte. And my feeling is the majority of these are probably full of sugar. So let's go across. 13 grams. Oh, the first one yesterday was 17 grams of sugar. Today's is 31 grams of sugar, 17 grams of sugar, 17, 17, 17, 17. Yeah, they're all 17. One's 21, 21, 17, 17, and 17. So they all have a lot of sugar. And I don't usually drink cappuccino. I used to drink it a lot, but I don't drink it a lot. I don't drink it anymore. So it's been a long time. It's like 2004, 2005. I was driving like an hour to work every day. So I would always stop at like Speedway and I would get a cappuccino and I would drink it on my way to work. I really needed the energy during that time because I had little kids at home. And yeah, I just really needed the energy. And since then, I started drinking like coffees with like sugar-free peppermint mocha, sugar-free this and sugar-free that. But even those are still full of seed oils. So I've gotten away from that recently. And now I'm just drinking my coffee either with like half and half, which no sugar, or whipping cream. And I just kind of whip it up a little bit and make it like a froth. And it doesn't have any sugar. So that's usually how I drink my coffee. I will add Lakanto. Sugar-free sugar, and it's not even sweet, honestly. But yeah, this stuff, it's just so sweet. It really is. Okay, today we are going to talk about family traditions. So if you want to hear about some of our family traditions, hang around. We are going to go into the living room and have a little chat. Okay, everyone, welcome back. So I wanted to share some family traditions. We don't have a lot of family traditions, but the ones that we have are special to us. So one of the first traditions we have is setting up of the Christmas tree. When I was younger, my brother and I used to set up the Christmas tree. My mom would help. My dad would kind of sit back and supervise the project. He would say, okay, you need one over here. Like, you know, the ornament, you need an ornament over here on this side. You need an ornament higher up. My mom's job was always to put the angel or the star. I think we always had an angel. We might've had a star a couple of times, But my mom would help my brother and I. My brother and I would put the ornaments on the tree. We would decorate the tree. And that's always been a family tradition. But now my brother is gone and it's just me. So I'm not decorating. I have decorated the tree and I do help decorate the tree. But as we got older, my parents started having the grandchildren decorate the tree. So the grandchildren would come over and start decorating the tree. And that was always fun. And now, what just happened? I think we lost a light. We're having technical difficulties. All right, so it solved the problem. My mom came into the kitchen with her walker, and sometimes when she steps down, it makes a loud thump and it kind of messed with my electricity. So one of my lights went out, and it's very early in the morning. So it's still kind of dark in the house. So I've got two ring lights. I've got the dining room light on. We don't have any lights in the living room. So that's why it's always dark in here. Plus, we have darker paneling on the wall. Actually, it's wood. Anyways, back to our story before the lights went out. My parents always had my brother and I decorate the tree. And then when the grandchildren, my children and his children were younger, the grandchildren started decorating the tree. But now my children are older. My son is 37 and my youngest is 22. So they all have their own children. So now the great grandchildren and my grandchildren are decorating the tree. So this past Christmas, or excuse me, this past Thanksgiving, not this past Christmas, this past Thanksgiving, I came up with the idea of having my kids set up the tree, set up the train, and having my grandchildren decorate the tree. I only had one grandchild here this Thanksgiving. Well, I had a couple more, but they're way too little. Sailor and Aiden are just way too little to decorate the tree. So having the great grandchildren slash grandchildren decorate the tree is just. It's just passing on the tradition of having the children decorate the tree. So that's always fun. So that is one family tradition. And then the newest family tradition is hiding Elf. So my mom bought Elf at the Dollar Tree and she bought him when he was still a dollar. And I don't know how she came up with the idea, but this is about the time when Elf on the Shelf was first coming out and it was pretty popular. But she came up with the idea of just hiding Elf and then having everybody find him. So you would hide Elf and wherever you found him, like if he's in the cupboard, if he's in the bookshelf, wherever he's at, the person that finds him gets to hide him the next time around. I hid Elf. She didn't tell me she found him. She must have found him because he's gone and I didn't know that she found him. But he's gone. He's not where I put him. So she found him. But we hide Elf and we just take turns finding him and then rehiding him. And we do that up until Christmas. So that's our newest tradition, which we started about 4 or 5 years ago. We started, I think, like in 2018. And here it is, 22. So it's been 4 years. So that's the newest tradition. Another tradition that we've been doing for a very long time is making gingerbread houses. However, we do not go to the store and buy the gingerbread package all packaged up. We don't do any of that. What we do is we buy graham crackers and we do a lot. I know a lot of preschools do this. And full disclosure, I'm a teacher and my degree is in early childhood education. So you know where this idea comes from. We take graham crackers and frosting and just build the houses that way, and then go to the store, just the Dollar Tree, buy some graham crackers, buy a little bit of frosting, and then some candies, and let the kids build their own little gingerbread houses out of graham crackers and frosting. And we've been doing that for several years now, I think maybe 6 or 7. And my oldest grandchildren, my granddaughter just turned 12, and then my next oldest is 11, and then 9, and then down from there. And of course, Sailor and Aiden, 1 and just like 1 month. So that is the second tradition that we have done. We haven't done this in a while, but a lot of times, times during the Christmas holidays, we would make salt dough and make salt dough ornaments. We haven't done that one for a while. And then let just all the family members decorate the salt dough ornaments. So that's always been fun. Another thing is having family members draw names. Like, because now, like, my kids are older. My youngest son is at university and he's downstate and he can't afford to buy everybody gifts and, you know, try to make it on his own and pay for college and all of that, because he's trying to pay for college as he works through college. So he's not taking out a lot of student loans. So he doesn't really have a lot of money to be buying everybody gifts. So in situations like that, just having family members draw names and see who they are going to buy for Christmas. We haven't done that in a long time either, but that is one of the traditions that we have done in the past. So I have written down like 4 different traditions that we've done during the holiday season. And I'm trying to remember what the other one was. Decorating the tree, the gingerbread houses with graham crackers, hiding elf, and then just decorating around the house. We've done that for a few years, but just recently gotten into it much more heavily than what we have in the past, because all the kids are gone. You know, my kids are all grown. They have kids of their own. And it just makes it fun when they come and to see. And they were so excited this Thanksgiving. They're like, oh, yeah, the house looks really cute. So that was nice. You know, they got to enjoy what the house looked like during the holiday season for Thanksgiving anyway. And now we're all decorated for Christmas. And when they come back for Christmas, they're going to see new decorations up. I can't think of anything else other than, oh, decorating sugar cookies. We've done a lot of that in the past as well. I like to have the grandchildren help me make cookies. So that's a big one. My granddaughter will be here sometime during the last week of our Vlogmas. So I would like to include her in some of our Vlogmas videos if her mother will allow it, of course, naturally, and if she wants to be. But anyways, on that note, if you have any family traditions that you do every year, please leave them in the comments below. And yeah, just, you know, let's start a conversation below of different traditions all of us had, because we can learn from each other. And I think that's the best way, and how a lot of traditions are born. So yeah, on that note, I'm going to go ahead and say goodbye. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you tomorrow in Vlogmas number 13.